Hello students, welcome to Adarsh Vidyalaya Maths Online class. In the last class, we discussed about addition, subtraction and multiplication of integers. Now, we are going to study the division of integers. So, before seeing this division of integers, let us recall addition, subtraction and multiplication of integers. Here, why we started integers first? Because most of the people having more doubt in this concept, integers concept only. So, they can do all the problem, but while adding the plus and minus or subtracting plus and minus or multiplying plus and minus, they will get more doubt. So, to clear that doubt only, first we started here integer concept. Okay. Now, in the previous classes, you learned addition, subtraction and multiplication. I hope everyone tried with some problem with one number. You got some clear idea. Even if you are not getting clear idea, repeatedly if you practice means you can get clear idea about integers. Because this is very basic for you. With this concept, we are solving all the units. Not only in our maths, even in physics, chemistry also you can use this logic. So, be thorough this integer concept, then automatically you can score good mark in maths. Okay, so without mistakes, that plus and minus sign, if you are doing the sum, easily can score good mark in your maths. So, repeatedly you have to watch the same videos, get clear idea, practice well, then you can score nice mark. Now, we will see division of integers. Here I wrote some formulas. Just I'll read. First listen. So the first one, plus divided by plus, you will get plus. Plus divided by minus equal to minus. Minus divided by plus equal to minus. Minus divided by minus equal to plus. I think this type of formulas, the same concept you got in multiplication also. Only one change is that instead of this division symbol, there you studied multiplication symbol. So, two signs, two integers we are taking, both also positive or both also negative. You will get the resulting answer is only positive, okay, in multiplication as well as division. That rule you have to keep in mind. Similarly, two integers we are taking, one is positive and one is negative. If you are multiplying the two integers or if you are dividing the two integers, that is one positive and one negative integers, the resulting answer will be only negative. So, the rules are same for both multiplication and division. That calculation part alone, yeah, a little changes there. So, multiplication means we will multiply and write. Division concept, we are going to divide and write the results here. Okay. Now, we will see one formula with simple example. Easily, you can get clear idea. Then, you can solve in your own. Let us start with the first formula. Plus divided by plus. I will take one simple example. Plus 14 is divided by plus 2. So, simple table only I took. Plus 14 divided by plus 2. So, like this coming means, if you know the table, directly we can divide. Otherwise, we can convert this division form into fraction form. See here, that is equal to plus 14 divided by plus 2. Here both also plus sign. So, what answer you will get? Only plus. Now, here we can cancel 14 and 2, both also common table 2. We can cancel these two, we will get number 7. So, our answer is plus 7. So, plus 14 is divided by plus 2, you will get plus 7. Okay, I will take one some big number. Plus 85 is divided by plus 5. So, what you will get? Plus 85 divided by plus 5. So, plus divided by plus is plus 85 and 5, both also cancelled by 5 table. So, for this we are using the test of divisibility knowledge. So, here 5, here also 5 coming in one's place, we can say this number is a multiple of 5. So, we are using the 5th table and we are cancelling these two, 5 1 times, here 5 1 time, remainder 3, 35, 7 5 is a 35. So, answer is plus 17. Okay, now we will see that next example, that is plus number. Plus integer is divided by negative integer. Positive integer I will take one number plus 124 is divided by minus 4. Okay, here one number is plus, one number is minus. So you will get this one as plus 124 is divided by minus 4. Now first you see the sign plus by minus. So whenever you are using the division concept or integer concept, there first we have to see the sign only. So plus divided by minus, we can write here minus. Then you see the number, the two numbers getting cancelled or not. We can cancel these two numbers by 4 table. So 4 1 time here, 4 3 times here 1 time. So answer is minus 31. 31 by 1 is 31. So minus 31. So plus divided by minus. So positive integer is divided by negative integer. You will get negative integer. Okay. Now we can take one more sum. Plus 205 is divided by minus 3. Now see here. Plus 205 is divided by minus 3. So first what we are going to do, plus and this minus, divide means you will get minus. 205 divided by 3. Here see, fraction coming, this number is divisible by 3 or not, easily we can check by using test of divisibility rule. For 3, we will use sum of all digits. Just you have to add and see, 2 plus 0 plus 5 is 7. 7 is not divisible by 3. So we can write the answer directly, 205 by 3. Suppose in question they are asking in decimal form, we can write decimal also. So in MCQ or multiple choice question, they will ask the answer. Sometimes they will give in fraction form, sometimes they will give in decimal form. So just you have to refer the answer and then you can give answer for that problem. Okay, so according to your options only, we are going to say whether the answer will be in decimal form or in fraction form. Okay, now we will see the third formula, that is minus by plus. That means negative integers we are going to take first. Minus 45 is divided by positive integers, I am going to take here 3. Okay, now we will check this one. Minus 45 is divided by plus 3. First we will see the sign only now. So minus divided by plus, what you will get? Minus. Now 45, 3, the 2 also getting cancelled by 3 table. If you are thorough in table, easily you can say 3, 15 times is 45. So minus 45. Okay. So negative integer is divided by positive integers. You will get negative integer only. Let us see one more example. Minus 128 is divided by plus 2. Okay. Now minus 128 is divided by plus 2. That is equal to minus divided by plus is minus 128 by 2. That is 64. So 2 1 time here. 12 coming means 6 2 is 12. And 4 times 8 we can say 4 times. 4 2 is 8. So 64 minus 64. So if you are taking first negative integer is divided by positive integer, we are getting that only negative integer. Okay. Now see that next last concept, negative by negative. That means negative integers we are going to take and divide by negative integers. Minus 12 is divided by minus 4. We can write minus 12 by minus 4. So minus by minus is plus. So minus by minus is plus. 12 by 4 is 3. Okay. 12 by 4 will be 3. So, two negative integers we are taking and dividing, you will get the resulting answer is only positive. One more sum, minus 200 is divided by 5, minus 5. So, what you will get? Minus 200 divided by minus 5. So, negative by negative, what you will get? Positive. 200 by 5, that is 40. Okay. Now, we are going to recall the concept what you learn now. So in division of integers we are using only the four concept. First one is I said plus divided by plus. So positive integer by positive integer, you will get only positive. Same like positive integer by negative means you will get negative. Negative by positive is negative. Both also negative means you will get positive. So in multiplication and division concept we are using the same rule. the two sides are same and we are either multiplying or dividing, you will get only positive. If one is positive and one is negative, you will get only negative in both multiplication and divisions of integer. Okay students, and if you practice more concept using this all addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, you can be thorough the concept of integers. So everyone practice well and try some questions with the own number, then automatically you can get clear idea. Okay students, now we will see one simplification method. See here, altogether I took all the four sign, addition, subtraction, multiplication and division with the positive and negative integers. How we are going to solve this one? See these two problem, if you try this easily you can get clear idea, and without mistakes you can solve your sums also. Let us start with the first sum, minus 5 plus of minus 3 minus of minus 4 into plus 3 is divided by minus 3. So already you learned Bodmer's rule, bracket of division, multiplication, addition and subtraction. Using this rule only we are going to simplify this one. So in one problem we are having more than one sign, we can apply this rule, as well as if you are having bracket concept also. So you learn more brackets, that is square bracket, set bracket, parenthesis and bar, like this coming means we will remove one by one, innermost bracket we will remove and we will solve that concepts. Same like we are going to solve this first and second sum using this Bodmer's rule. Let us start with the first one, minus 5 plus 3 minus of minus 4 into plus 3 is divided by minus 3. See in this rule, first letter bracket, here we are not having separate bracket, that is suppose having one square common bracket or one parenthesis coming means we will simplify that one first. But here I didn't give any bracket, but we are having different signs in between the two integers, we are having plus minus, multiplication symbol and division also. So using this rule, first we are going to take Bodmer's division. So first we are going to divide these two numbers. So other number you write as it is, minus 5 plus of plus 3 minus of minus 4 into this one alone I am going to take separately, bracket inside, plus 3 is divided by minus 3. Here we can cancel these two 3, we will get number 1, plus by minus is we can say 1. So that answer is minus 5 plus of plus 3 minus of minus 4 into plus by minus is minus, we know that answer is 1. Okay, next we are going to take multiplication concept. Here we, these two having multiplication, no? So we can multiply these two number. So minus 5 plus of plus 3 minus minus into minus what? Plus 4 ones are 4. So plus 4. Okay, now we are having only plus and minus symbol. So if you are having multiplication and division symbol, first we have to simplify that part, and then we are having only plus and minus means we can use removing bracket concept. So we are going to multiply signs alone inside of the bracket, then automatically we can remove bracket here. So this number I'll write here, minus 5 plus of plus is plus 3 minus of plus, so minus into plus is minus 4. Okay, now we are going to use again this Bodmer's rule. So next we are having what sign? Addition. So here plus sign only come, you know, so minus 5 plus 3, so you will get 1 negative 1 positive. So we can subtract means what you will get? Minus 2. Greater number sign minus, so this 5 only, so minus 2, this one is minus 4. So minus 2 minus 4 is equal to, now both also negative, so we can add and put the same sign, minus 6. Okay, so in this problem I gave all four operations, arithmetic operations I gave, we simplified using Bodmer's rule. So you know the clear idea about Bodmer's, bracket of division, multiplication, addition and subtraction. So in one problem we are having more than one sign, we are going to remove using this rule only, keep these ideas in mind. And bracket also you learn in 7th standard and 8th standard also. So we are removing bracket one by one only. So using this bracket concept, innermost bracket first we will simplify. So that ideas later we will discuss. Now we are seeing only integer concept. So use all the four signs arithmetic operators using means we are solving like this way only. Okay, let us see the second exercise, second example sum, that is plus 3 into minus 4 is divided by minus 12. So here I gave only the two operators, one is multiplication, another one is division. So as usual, using the rule, we are going to divide these two numbers first. So you will get plus 3 into minus 4 divided by minus 12. Now minus divided by minus is what? Plus. So plus 3 into plus 4 and 12. We can cancel it. Here 1, here 3. So you will get result is 1 by 3. Okay. Now here only the two terms, the two also multiplying here. So plus into plus, what you will get? Plus. The numbers you see 3 into 1 by 3. Here 3, 3 getting cancelled, you will get number 1 only. So 1 ones are 1. So the answer is what? Plus 1. So in one problem we are having more than one arithmetic operators. We will use only Bodmer's rule. Using the Bodmer's rule, we are solving the sums. Okay. Clear, students? Thank you.